Specialty coffee. This is all about today. But what specialty coffee should be? Fresh. Specialty coffee should be fresh. How can we say about specialty coffee when we grind our coffee at the backstage 30 minutes ago? Those rich aromas locked up in the beans are begging to come out and complement your experience. But we'll only enjoy these benefits if the coffee preparation is up to standard, and that starts at the very beginning. I decided to grind my coffee right here on stage to minimize oxidation, to prevent the loss of precious oils, and minimize depletion caused by CO2. By brewing with fresh grind and not pre-ground coffee, I am making the most of my coffee's characteristics. The first moment it is grounded up, it is at its best. Just like when we grind it at the coffee shop. This coffee is freshly roasted 3 days ago to Actron 77 for 8 minutes. This profile increases vibrancy and all the beautiful citrus flavors that you will experience later on in your cup. As most food items, fresh is better. And coffee is no exception, especially during filter coffee. What do we look for in an extraordinary cup? I want silkiness in body texture, significant sweetness and clarity in the finish. That's why I am using Gem Series Dripper today. I found the lid creates a closed thermosystem. The steam produces trap, resulting in higher kinesis heat by 4 degrees. This means the water is being pushed with a higher pressure and has more straight contact time with the coffee oils, highlighting the body texture of my beverage. It has 12 horizontal ribs in the midsection to slow the water flow for longer contact time and extracts caramel-like sweetness. 12 vertical ribs at the bottom for fast extraction, resulting in clean aftertaste. I am using 15 grams of ground coffee, 250 ml of water to brew 220 ml of beverage. I pre-infuse for 30 seconds with 50 ml for proper degas. Then 70 ml at 40 seconds for the first stage of aromatics and acids. ml at 1 minute as acids turn to sweetness and body. And lastly, 70 ml for lower extraction to balance the cup. Time is closely related to grind size. I am using 400 to 600 microns with total brew time of 2 minutes for a clean finish. My water has total hardness of 160 ppm to soften the acidity. Temperature was set at 92 degrees and finished at 88 in the brew for an intense aroma. All the above are resulting to a range TDS of 130 to 140 for intensity in flavors and syrupy body texture. Clean and transparent. Specialty coffee should be clean and transparent. We lost that at some point, as we have seen everything. Deep fermentation, experiments, infused coffees, and lots of things that affected the result. when extreme processing and fermentation don't allow us to understand the variety, the origin and the characteristics of the coffee, then we had lost the destination. This geisha grows slowly on beautiful trees in Panama, at Finca Deborah Farm, more precisely in the region of Volcan. The plantation is at 1900 meters above the sea level, with ideal conditions for coffee production. The processing. We talk a lot about processing. Many people, many farms, many producers invested in deep fermentation the last 3 to 4 years, and somehow we lose the true character of the coffee. This coffee has been processed by the classic traditional washed method, with special care in all stages. The combination of perfect selection, hand washing, depulping, and drying in one layer for 15 days gives exceptional flavor to this new crop. Typical geisha characteristics are elevated, gaining floral notes and bright acidity. Sensory experience. Specialty coffee should engage the mind, the heart, and the senses all the way. Please keep some notes about the taste description. When the coffee is hot, in the aroma you will find floral notes of orange blossom, followed by chamomile and caramel. In the flavor you will find sweet orange, chamomile, yellow honey and peach. The aftertaste is long-lasting and sweet, and you will find the refreshing touch of pink grapefruit. Please swirl very well and evaluate the aroma straight from the carafe. There you are. When the coffee is warm, it becomes more transparent. In the flavor, you will find more citrus fruits like mandarin orange. In the aftertaste, you will find apricot. The acidity is citric, medium in intensity, like sweet orange. Body, medium in intensity, with syrupy body texture. When the coffee is cold, the structure gives an amazing balance. In the flavor, you will find lemongrass. In the aftertaste, you will find chamomile. The acidity is citric, medium to high in intensity, like sweet lime. Body, medium in intensity, smooth. Citrus fruits are found through flavor to the acidity, working in harmonious balance. And overall, this is a very delicate cup. Floral and fruity when hot, refined and elegant when warm. When the coffee is hot, please use your cupping spoon. For warm, drink directly from the glass. When it's cold, following my instructions. When the coffee cools down, please leave your notes down. Take the liquid in your mouth and place the other hand on the silky texture and feel it from top to bottom. Hold the coffee in your mouth just for a few seconds, roll it around, exposing to all your taste buds, keep touching the silk, and think about the silky texture, the transparent character, and the elegance of this geisha. Please keep the menu as it is part of the experience. Whenever we taste coffee, we are taking in visual, aromatic, tactile, auditory, and taste informations all at the same time. That was all about today in 2 words. Specialty coffee. Time.